Welcome back, everyone, to another episode in Planet Zoo. And slowly but surely, we're getting everything laid out here and getting a little bit better. I do believe, though, that we need to get in another animal pretty quick here. Our money is going up currently, but we need to get another exhibit in here. And so I am thinking I would like to go ahead and put in another North American animal. And I was looking through the wiki, what do they call this thing again? The Zoopedia, sorry. And came across these pronghorn antelope. And then also in their habitat, we can put the American bison. So let's go ahead and do that habitat. And I'm thinking, right over here, we have a nice little work area right between these two exhibits. So let's go ahead and put it out right over here. It's gonna have to be pretty good size. Let's go ahead and look here. How big do you want this thing? You're not bad, okay, but let's look at the American bison. Right here, and how big? Okay, not too bad. So he needs a grade 3. And the pronghorn needed 4 1/4 feet high. So let's go ahead and get our barrier in. All right, I think it's time. We've got just a basic. I have no clue what's gonna happen with these American bison. So we are gonna go ahead and get some. Go ahead and get a few American bison. I have a feeling that they're, everything's gonna be very, very simple in their exhibit because American bison are out on the plains. Oh, all I can get is a female, huh? Well, let's go ahead. We will get, let's look at the genetics. Yeah, I don't mind that one at all. Okay, but you're a little bit, no, you're a little bit older. Let's get this youngest one and move you to here. Okay, and then let's go get our pronghorn. Oh, there we go. There's a male. Let's go ahead and get him, I guess. Okay, I gotta stop for a second because we have got our first one was delivered. Okay, and now let's go back over here to our animal trading. Go here. And I went to get a pronghorn. A female and a male of these. Not a lot of options here. Well, we're gonna apparently have to get him. Yeah, and move you to here. I need, oh my gosh, there's only one female left. Okay, well, better grab you. Put you in here too. All right, now we have all of our animals ordered up and ready to go. Let's go ahead now, and first off, let's look at his, okay, let's get our vets. I need to get a vet, one of these vets, doing this one. And then when the other one gets there, I will get her going on the other one. But we definitely can feed them. And let's go ahead and get on the bison, please. The American bison. Let's get some food in here for these guys. So let's get one of the big one. Let's get a biggie. And, oh, I want to move that. Can I move that? I want to move it over here so people can see it. And then also a water trough. I do want to put in some water in here, but we're going to go ahead and see. Now, let's look at your terrain. You're fine with the habitat. Wow, the terrain. You could use some more sand and a little bit less. So let's go ahead and, yeah, a little bit less rock. So, a little bit more soil. Okay, a little bit less rock. You don't like all this rock. I know, I was doing it more for decor. Let's go ahead and get over here. Here is some more of this rock. Okay, you're a little bit more happy. go ahead and get some of this soil. Let's get this a big thing and turn down the intensity and just get a couple dots around here. And you still have too much rock, huh? But you could use some more sand. Okay, let's go ahead and use the grass here. And get rid of some more of this rock. Okay, and you do want a little bit of more sand, just a tad. Just boop. There we go. Okay, now let's look at plants. You are fine. 100% fine with the plants. So we're gonna go ahead and get the pronghorn in here. And see what the pronghorn says. What? Okay, let's go ahead and just stop for a second. And now let's go ahead and look at our habitat. And we want to put in the pronghorn. Antelope, let's see if that changes. It did. A water trough large, but it's the same feeding trough, so we should be okay. Same feeding trough. Do we have anything that we can give them an enrichment for? A rubbing pillar. We can do a rubbing pillar. Let's put this in right here. I'm gonna have to move a lot of this. Why can't I put this down? There we go. Put it there. Put that there. Put a barrel right here. And an ice block right there. Okay. It gives them something. Okay, now let's look at the terrain for you. Oh, there is no hard shelter. Okay, so we will make a hard shelter for you. Okay, but you're okay with everything else. And plant-wise, you're okay too. But you'll take as many plants as you want. Interesting. Okay, so it's grassland. Let's go ahead and stick with grassland. The American Plains bison is characterized by its large head, shoulder hump, and forequarters, all of which are covered in a shaggy coat. Their hindquarters are comparatively less muscular, with a thinner coat. Bisons are not currently endangered, but are hunted to near extinction in the 19th century, with the original pre-colonization population of 50 million being reduced to just 1,000. Bison live in herds with multiple social dynamics, which can range in size from 15 to 400 individuals. Females live in interrelated groups with their offspring, while young males live in bachelor herds until they reach full growth at around 6 years of age, at which point they become a solitaire dominant bull. Some of the fun facts are the bison is the largest land animal in North America. They can run 35 miles per hour when charging at full speed. They do have poor eyesight, but have excellent hearing and a great sense of smell. Male calves born early in the breeding season are more likely to grow up to become a dominant bull. Bisons have been observed rubbing themselves against strong-smelling trees, such as cedar and pine, believing this to be a deterrent to biting insects. The pronghorn antelope is in fact not a true antelope. While the North American mammal occupies a similar environment niche to antelope, hence the same name being used, for this reason is often simply referred to as the pronghorn. It has a tan-colored coat on its back and sides and a white underbelly and white chevron-shaped markings on its neck. Some of the fun facts about the pronghorn. Although colloquially called an antelope, the pronghorn is actually more closely related to a giraffe. Pronghorn antelope are the second fastest land animal after the cheetah and can run at 61 miles per hour. However, they can run at high speeds for much longer than the cheetah. Pronghorn antelope have a lot of adaptations for speed and agility, including a large heart and lungs, light bones, and shock-absorbent hooves. Pronghorns have light, glossy hairs on their rump, which stands up and catches the light, when the pronghorn is alarmed, acting as a warning to other herd members. Although this beastie can jump up to 20 feet in one bound, they prefer to crawl underneath obstacles rather than jump over them.
Thank you.
you everyone for joining me today in our little bison and pronghorn antelope enclosure. I hope you guys all like it. I think it turned out really well. I am not too sure we're going to be able to keep the pronghorn antelope in here. They get very, very skittish. Oh, look at this one. She's carrying a little ball. Is that not cute? But they get really skittish. They do not like the visitors. This big, huge window really upsets them. Let's see. Are you getting all stressed out? No. No. But they do. They also get very upset when it snows. Very upset. And I usually have to put them into the trading center because then I get picketers out here because people don't like it when the animals are all stressed out. But I hope that you guys all enjoyed our build today, and I hope you learned a lot, and I hope to see you back for our next episode. Everyone, please leave a like and a comment. We'd love to know if you'd like to see me do something specific or if you have any ideas for our little zoo. And also, if you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. We will see you all back next time. Thank you.